I'd like to talk to you about the Heil BM17 headphones. They're absolutely fantastic. I've had mine 2 weeks. However, there is one slight error. Normally, this microphone drops and it stops on some kind of step in there. And I can feel there is something there, but it's basically going straight past. So it's falling down there. Not many people want to hear what's going on my shoulder during a transmission. So although it's literally just a couple of weeks old, I don't have the confidence to send it back to the radio distributor that I bought it from in Toronto. I will take a look myself and fix it, and worst case, I will use the element from this in a pro set. But I would like to try and fix these and understand what's going wrong, because they are a very good headset and gives good audio, and I've invested the time in setting them up, so let's fix them. Here we go. So I guess really the first thing we should do with these wonderful things is actually unplug them from the radio. Would be a good move. So let's do that. Earphones and microphones out from the radio. Quick investigation on the internet, there's zero information on these, so I guess I'm the only person that's had this problem right now. But just to clarify, normally the microphone would go to about there and it would hit some kind of a stop, presumably inside the earphone area, and this isn't. It's wobbling around. There's something loose. It's, yeah, it could just be a screw. So that's what I'm hoping it is, but how do you gain access to it? I'm wondering whether underneath this little stainless steel cap with IC written on it, there's maybe a screw in there or the inside. I don't particularly really want to destroy this cap if I don't need to. So I'm going to take the foam earmuff on and see if I can have a look from the inside before I do anything. Very tight. Normally these foam pieces around here just easily come off, but this is just anything but easy. I can't even see. I don't know whether it snaps out or what, but with zero information on the internet, you've got to find out, right? No, it's not snapping out. And the fabric does move. Yes, the fabric's coming off. Okay, it just needed a little bit more of a stern yank to remove that. So here we go. It's there's the fabric separated. That's okay. You can see roughly which is the top. It's kind of oval shaped. Okay, now what do we do? This foam here, it appears to be stuck down with some kind of glue, so I'm just rolling it back. Take a quick peek inside. No, roll some more. There we go. Does have some kind of glue on there. Almost looks like that kind of wood glue, a bit of yellowy stuff. Yep, that's come off quite easily. So what do we see now? Not a lot useful. I see two recesses here. I'm not sure whether they're screws, I just can't see down there. Let's get a torch and have a look. No, I think they're just air holes, just to allow some movement of air. There's no screws underneath those. So, we're back to, this is the possible point of entry here. What do we do? Guess stick a knife blade onto the edge and see if it comes loose. Oh, I can feel actually in the centre there under that IC, I could actually feel a dimple, so I wouldn't mind betting there's a screw under there. Let's have a little look. Ordinarily, I would warm this up with a hot air gun, but I'm not worried. And there we are, indeed, a small posy here. So let's. Let's pause for a second and go and get a driver to see what we can do with that. Alright, what have we got here? Fits perfectly. It is a PH1x50, so a PH1. Yeah, PH1 driver. So let's see if we can just tighten it up from here. Yeah, there we go, it stops perfectly. So all that had happened there is this little set screw here had worked its way loose in 2 weeks. I'm not really sure whether we could put some thread lock on it, but I'm not going to be replacing that the IC sticker on. Oh yeah, what the heck, let's see if the IC sticker goes back on. It does indeed. And that drops nicely now. It's pretty much perfect. There's still some movement there, which there was brand new. It drops and stops, yeah. And the pressure on there doesn't take it past either, so if I don't want to break anything inside, I'm happy with that. That's as planned. So now we have to stick the bits and pieces back together here, which we didn't actually need to take off. So let's see if that foam will just stick back onto the glue residue that's there. It's going to be held in by this anyway, so it doesn't really matter. So the answer is no, it doesn't stick down there. I guess on assembly at the plant that's easier. And then we just stick this piece back on. Are there any loose points there? It actually looks kind of looser at the bottom, like someone's had their finger there. Remember, I removed it the other way around. It's actually pretty much a circle, so I shouldn't think it matters too much. well, that is a circle from the speaker case in there anyway. So let's just get that back on somehow. I've seen reassembly of things like this with people have actually put a cord inside and then just pulled the cord round and it just pops the sleeve over on its own. But this is just literally by hand. Yeah, it doesn't, it's not too difficult. I guess you just got to keep the areas pinched so you don't want them undoing. So in hindsight, looking at this, I should have started at the top and worked my way around to the bottom, because now I'm at the top doing the last bit. It's quite fiddly with the headset here, this limited amount of movement. But yeah, I felt that going, that's nice. So does it look the same as the other side? Yes, it does. We're back in business. One final check. Yep, a few more hours of ham radio yet.
So this video, if you like it, our video, comment down below a thumbs up.
Thanks for watching VA3SII. Bye.